What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Get A-List Fit Show. I'm Jaron Fran. Thanks so much for listening in. I appreciate you. And I talk all things about health and wellness, personal development, confidence, a little bit of theater nerd in me, and some dad life, because that's who I am. And I'm feeling a little spicy today, and I want to get right into it. You gotta stop. Stop forcing it. Stop forcing the workouts. It is no coincidence that the people out there that have the hardest time losing weight or putting on muscle are the same ones that are forcing themselves to go work out, that are forcing themselves to, you know, change their diet. That's not how it works. You're doing it wrong. You gotta understand that the more you force it, the less likely it's going to happen. Now, that sounds like a universal woo-woo-ness, but I have to consistently remind my hardest working clients that you got to take a rest day. I have to remind hard workers to actually pull back a little bit. And this hits me home because I see myself as a hard worker. It doesn't make sense to people like you and I that naturally want to put in 100% of our effort. I had a voice teacher one time tell me, "You're trying too hard. Your voice sounds very effortful. It's not what you're doing. It's about what you're not doing. You need to pull back and relax into it a little bit." And I think I told the story on the podcast that, you know, when I was teching a show and it was a tap number and we were doing it over and over and over again to the point where I was getting exhausted. And finally, the director said on the last take, like, "You know what? That was your best performance yet of that song." And I was like, "How could it be?" It was because I was so exhausted that I let go. I threw my hands up in the air and I was just being on stage. And we know that we can't control ourselves too much to the point where everything's so contrived. We really have to just be present in the moment. Well, the same type of thing goes along with working out, and I'll explain a little bit more. So if you're dragging yourself to the gym out of guilt, or if you feel like you're punishing yourself by dieting and cutting calories, that is not sustainable. It will not work. And that's why I have such a bone to pick with 75 hard, the 75 hard challenge. Love the concept behind it because anything that gets you up and gets you moving, amazing. But what happens after 75 day? What happens on day 76 where you just like quit and you stop? Or maybe you try to do it all over again, but inevitably your stamina is burnt out. Like, to me, like 75 days of strict workouts, usually two workouts a week is what the rules are. I'm not about that. I'm not about going extra hard now so that you see results, because those results usually are temporary. If you force yourself to work out as a punishment and as a chore, it's never going to become a true part of your life that you enjoy. So if that sounds familiar, you start off strong, you know, 2 weeks into your workout because you're pushing yourself, and then you're like, wait, week three, oh God, you're back to square one. Because why? You gave up. You burnt out. You lost motivation. You lost excitement. Of course, that's going to happen. So you can't look at it as all or nothing. I did an episode on that a couple weeks ago. And by the way, I know I'm being hard on you, but it's because I know you can take it. It's not your fault. It's not your fault if you feel like you're relying on willpower and force to, you know, get yourself to the gym to try to make results happen. It's not your fault because there's something else going on at play here. You can put in all the effort in the world. You can try your hardest to lose weight, to gain weight, to build muscle, to lose fat. If you're still struggling and you're trying really hard, it's probably because your metabolism and your body is working against you. So just to get a little bit scientific here for a second, people that are forcing themselves to work out are probably putting the cart before the horse, right? Meaning, like, a lot of people want to lose fat fast. Of course, let's lose weight as fast as possible, except your body might not be ready to lose weight. Like, you actually might not be ready for a diet. Do you even know, bro? Do you work out, bro? No. Do you even know your metabolic score? Do you understand where your metabolism is sitting at? I'm going to guess, unless you're one of my clients, the answer is no. You don't understand where your metabolism is at. Again, it's not your fault. It's not your fault. I'm not yelling at you. I'm just instructing and trying to point out the fact that the fitness industry is lying to you. They're trying to sell you supplements for quick weight loss. They're trying to force you into 75-day hard because that's what everybody else seems to be doing, and maybe it's working. Or they're trying to get you to pay for the next Barry's Bootcamp class or the next Orange Theory class. Look, I'm not out here to pick a fight with them. I love anything that gets you inspired to get you up and moving. However, you've got to take a step back and get strategic and get clear on where you're at right now. You might not even be ready for a diet. And what that means is you might not be ready for fat loss right away. The majority of my clients, we need to do a little bit of healing and making sure that your body is primed for fat loss. When your body is primed for fat loss, you lose weight faster. And guess what? It stays off longer. Why would you put in all this work to maybe see a little bit of results, but it doesn't stick around? When you rely on willpower alone, you're pushing your body too hard, most likely, without really understanding what it actually needs. People skip this step all the time, and that's what gets me so frustrated, because I see these fitness bros out there that are telling you to just, you know, eat less and move more. That's it, right? Calories in versus calories out. There's a little bit of science, of course, that goes into it. And yeah, on paper, that sounds great, but not everybody is ready for that stage. Not everybody is, you know, that's a cookie cutter advice. You need a custom approach. You need something that makes sense for your goals, for your body, for your metabolism, and your lifestyle. And that's why I've always said, like, not everyone's trying to be a bodybuilder out there. That's what's really big on YouTube. That's what like kind of got me into it. And then I quickly realized, like, this is so unsustainable. I never resonated with like the fitness bros out there. Like, literally, my first personal trainer, Brad, was a fitness bro that scared the shit out of me. I was so intimidated by him. And he just forced me to do more and to run faster and to eat less. And like, no offense, Brad, but that shit didn't work for me. In fact, it probably did more damage than it did good. It wasn't realistic for me. It wasn't what I wanted, and it wasn't what my body needed. So, stop with the BS workout. Stop forcing yourself to go work out. And instead, shift the perspective on getting clear on what your body needs and then finding a sustainable approach to get you there. Finding a way to enjoy this process, right? The power of the right plan is immense. Like, if you do it the right way, results can happen a lot faster than you think. Everyone's different. I call the first stage of my program A-list priming. We got to get your body primed for the A-list shape, right? A lot of my clients come to me because they want a tight waist, you know, definition in their abs, broad shoulders, like nice defined toned arms, strong glutes, a nice butt, a nice chest, you know? And to get there, we first need to examine, okay, where's your body really starting at? What is your personal custom starting point? That's why I like to understand what their metabolic score is. Again, if you don't know what that means, there's a link down below. You can fill out the quiz so I can help you with your metabolic score. Totally free, no strings attached. I can at least point you in the right direction. Get A-List Fit is that custom approach because, you know, not every client is the same, of course. So I like to guide them in different directions based on what they need. And if you found the right workout plan, and if you found the right diet plan that actually worked with your metabolism, with your body instead of against it, and that fits your body type, and it's aligned with your goals, oh man, it can be really exciting. All those years of struggling, all those years of questioning, like, why isn't this working for me? Why am I still holding on to weight? It starts to fade away, because then you're going to be really excited about what's happening, the magic that you're literally seeing in the mirror, because results are happening faster than you can even imagine. Now, you know, disclaimer, like, everyone's body's different again. Like, that's the whole point of this, right? But when you have the right strategy, you have the right support system, and you have the right plan, it can happen for you. It's possible. Just be careful of the BS that's out there in the online space about workouts and supplements and diet trends and all that BS, right? And be careful about starting in the wrong place. Start in the right place for you. Okay? Oh, and by the way, stop forcing it. Like I said, that's a whole deep mindset shift that I'll get into just in a second. But you want to understand your starting point. Have I made that clear? You got to prime your body for the most of us. Prime your body before you're ready for fat loss, then get into fat loss, and then boom, it can happen quick. Now back to the mindset shift. Remember, fitness has to be seen as self-care, not as a punishment. It's truly about nourishing your body and finding joy in the movement, like actually looking forward to your workouts. Can you imagine? You're not stressing about it. You just wake up and you do it and you look forward to it. Oh, that's such a freeing place to be. And same thing with your diet. You're not stressing about what to eat or what not to eat. You know what works for you. That's the place that I love to get my clients. Food freedom and let's call it movement freedom, or like looking forward to it. Like it sounds wildly unrealistic if if you're someone that's like, I hate working out, but I force myself to do it. Trust me, you can get there. You can get there. That's what the Get A List Fit method helps my clients do, and it can help you too. So the right routine for you is something that you can do for life, not just, you know, a 30-day challenge or a 75-day challenge. Stop forcing it. Start enjoying it. That's where the lasting change happens. And if you feel confused and you're curious about, well, what is the right plan for my lifestyle, or where is my body at? Do I need to prime my body, or am I ready for fat loss? Shoot me a DM on Instagram. Ask a question. Let me know you listen to this episode, and I'll get you the metabolic quiz, the Get A List Fit metabolic assessment for free. I usually charge people for this because it's an in-depth process. I save it for my VIP clients. You know, this is like a $500 thing, but I'm going to do it for free. If you're listening to this episode, click the link below. It's only up temporarily. You have access to it. And shoot me a message if you want on Instagram just to chat a little bit more if you have any questions. All right? I love you so much. Thanks for listening. Leave a review and let's get some clarity in our lives. Let's do what actually works for our bodies instead of just guessing. I want to provide motivation and inspiration, and again, most importantly, compel you into action. So do something today. Take the first step. Reach out to me. You got this. I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.